Today, we'll take a look at how you can combine your videos and still images together to make this cool scrapbook slideshow, all done in Final Cut Pro without having to download or install any plugins. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Down in our timeline, we have a couple of videos combined with a few still images and some background music that we're going to turn into a scrapbook slideshow. First thing we need to do is crop our stills to fill the entire frame. There's a couple of ways of doing this. One is you can use a transform tool and adjust the size and framing of your image. Another way of doing this is by changing the spatial conform parameter. With your clip selected, scroll down to the bottom of the video inspector and change the spatial conform from fit to fill. We can also use the Ken Burns effect to add a little bit of movement to our stills. Go through all your still images and adjust the size and framing to get rid of the black bars. Next, set your playhead between your first two clips and select either the end of your first clip or the start of your second clip. Open the transitions browser, select the stylized category, and scroll down to the scrapbook theme. Select one of these transitions and double click it to add it between your first two clips. The one I chose is the boomerang transition, which has four images and goes from the top left image to the bottom left. By default, for the two unused images in this transition, Final Cut Pro just duplicates your clips. So if we skim through it, we have two copies of the first clip and two of the second. To change these, click on the transition clip in your timeline to select it, and you'll see numbered handles appear in your timeline along with corresponding numbers over the image in the viewer. Drag any of these numbered handles in your timeline to select the frame to fill a corresponding area in the viewer. Select a different clip, and this way you don't have any duplicates in your transition. You can also ripple trim your transition to make your animation faster or slower. We'll go through our project and add transitions from this theme between all our clips. If you skim any of these transitions in the transitions browser, you'll notice most of the transitions here go from left to right. Final Cut Pro doesn't let you change the direction of these, but there is a workaround. Say for example, we want to use the pan lower right transition. By default, it moves from the top left to lower right. If we want to go the other way, here's how this can be done. First thing we need to do is reverse our clips. So if we want to start with this clip and transition to this one, we need to place a second clip before our first one. Next, if you're using video clips, you need to reverse the clip itself. Select a video clip and from the speed drop-down menu, select reverse clip. Place a marker on your music track at the start of your clip, on the cut between the clips, and at the end of your second clip. Ripple trim the start of your first clip and the end of your second clip to add about 1.5 seconds to each. Add your transition, and if necessary, move the numbered markers in your timeline to remove duplicates. Command click your two clips and the transition clip itself and combine them into a compound clip by pressing Option G on your keyboard. With your compound clip still selected, from the speed drop-down menu, once again, select reverse clip. Skim your clip, and with your playhead in the middle of the transition, press M on your keyboard to add a marker. Ripple trim the start of your compound clip so the middle markers line up. And ripple trim the end of your clip to your last marker. This way, if you add another transition to the start or the end of your compound clip, you still have extra media in your compound clip necessary for these transitions. Now, if you play back your compound clip, your two clips are played back in the right order, and the transition moves in reverse, so from bottom right to top left. Go through your entire project and add one of these transitions to every cut. Once done, let your project render out and you have a nice scrapbook slideshow, all done in Final Cut Pro. You can also do a similar slideshow in Final Cut Pro using other themes, such as the photo album theme, comic book theme, or even the bulletin board theme. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button, and if you haven't yet, check out the rest of my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.